Welcome back today at Yakayima TV. Today we have an interesting interview with Jasper den Best. He is professor at the Haas University of Applied Sciences in Den Bosch in the Netherlands, an institute where they are very active in research and applications in the agriculture world and food world. And Jasper will talk about vertical farming, as I said, and particularly about a specific research project he is being conducting with the partners at Brightbox. So Jasper, welcome. I would say let's start with your presentation.
Yeah, thank you for your introduction. Maybe introduce myself a little bit more. As said, I'm involved in agriculture, in education and in applied research. And Haas University started 11 or maybe 12 years ago with vertical farming. And at the university, you can still visit the oldest lead-lit climate cells in the Netherlands. I think they're sort of ancient and they're just over 10 years old. And later we joined Philips, now Signify and Botany, in the Brightbox in Venlo. When I meet people and we talk about vertical farming, and it really does not matter whether they are students or professionals, everybody talks about light recipes. And of course, they are very important. And next to light, I would say the complete climate. But not so often we talk about the differences that exist in the commercial varieties, in the cultivars that you can grow. And light research, light recipe research is quite complicated because you can test so many different combinations of light set points. And the varieties, yeah, normally you have a limited number of varieties, and when you test them, you get interesting results that you don't hear often about. So that actually is the research that we have carried out recently to check what variation you get if you only play with commercial varieties, with different cultivars, with genetics under LEDs in a vertical farm. I think I can switch to the presentation now.
Yeah. That is, I guess, on a specific type of lettuce or?
Yeah, we decided because everybody does lettuce research, so you can find some information there. So we thought, what is the other interesting group of crops next to the leafy vegetables? And then you end up in the herbs, both potted herbs and freshly cut herbs. And within the herbs, of course, there's so many different herbs, but in, for instance, basil herbs, there are different varieties, and also the different markets require different types. The taste of the Italians is not the same as the taste of the Dutch when it comes to basil. I would say they have a different taste, but actually they have a better taste when it comes to cooking and herbs.
The Italians, you mean?
The Italians,
yeah.
Let's be honest in that.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we tested a series of herbs, and I will show you two slides that give an impression of the presentation that I will do in autumn at the high-tech campus or online. So then, if you're interested, you're welcome to join the rest of the story later. I will share my screen so that I can show you. Yeah, this is the first slide. It gives an impression of the Brightbox in Venlo. And actually you see two pictures in the same slide. On the left hand side, we look into a path in between two racks with a multiple layer system. Actually we have five layers on top of each other, and we have four racks. And each layer is about 10 square meters of cultivation area. And the picture on the right hand side gives you a better impression of the facility. Here you see the four racks, and although that's difficult to see, each rack has a different LED recipe, and we, because it's a cooperation with Philips or Signify, we use their LEDs, and on the right hand side picture from the front to the back, you see blue and red LED, then white and red, and the last two racks have blue, red plus far red, and white, red plus far red. And these LEDs, whether you buy them from one company or the other, most of the companies would sell you this type of LED for the production of your crop. We simply put 25 different basal varieties from 6 different seed companies, Dutch, Italian, Israeli, and other, just to test what the effect is of the variety choice. And here you can see how it was carried out. And the pictures are taken the day before we ended the trials. We had an open day and we had a lot of visitors from Dutch and international seed companies, but also of professionals that are involved in vertical farming, mainly in the Netherlands, but also from a few surrounding countries. So in our case, Germany and Belgium. Because so far, in general, these trials are either not carried out yet, or people did it but did not share the results. And we wanted to know how important is the variety choice. And from the picture, when you look at the left-hand picture, this variety, and we took out some plants for collecting data, or this variety, it's equally old. It is grown in the same system, in the same climate, everything the same. So the difference that you see between the lowest level and the level on top is a genetical difference. And I think you can see that there is not a lot of statistics necessary to calculate that the yield of this variety is much higher than the yield of this variety. And actually, in 4 weeks' time, 4.5 weeks' time, you have this result, and you already know what varieties you should choose or test better, and which varieties you shouldn't test. And of course, kilograms is not the only important characteristic, also taste and maybe a certain type of plant model is important. Yeah, but here you can see the test.
So you mentioned indeed, if you look at the yield part, yes, then you can see that the let's say the mid level is the best compared to the bottom, so to speak. But the taste is, as you said, important as well. So how do you test that? Is that a subjective way of testing, or it depends on
So we collect two different types of data, the ones that we can measure in an objective way, so the length and the weight, things like that, whether we have flower induction already or not, and we can also measure the dry weight, for instance, and calculate the dry matter percentage. When it comes to more subjective things like taste, it is complicated to do that because we don't have a machine to do it. People have problems with tasting. So if we would do it in the right way, we need a taste panel like the one that Wageningen University has in Blijswijk, for instance. And they train people to taste things. And to be honest, when you have tasted three basal varieties, then you don't taste anything anymore, because the taste of basil can be quite intensive. So that's not so easy. So what we did with companies that came by, we asked them to taste it and to give their impression. And these people, yeah, they are used to tasting lettuce or whatever crop they sell. But that's very subjective. So there are actually two things. If we would have an Italian group and we would let them taste these varieties, then probably they recognize the ones from Italian companies, because the leaves look a bit different and the taste is really different. And they go for taste. Their kitchen is famous all over the world. And yeah, you do not find a lot of Dutch restaurants in the world. And if you find them, it's not top quality food normally. And so for us, it's the kilograms. So you're right. And this is something that really depends on the company that wants to see the results.
Okay, clear. Thank you.
We did do some shelf life tests with a company in Venlo that has business in cut herbs and prepacked herbs, to see if the shelf life is good. Because yeah, also in this business, people often think that the taste and also the shelf life is not good because it's an artificial environment. But actually the taste is quite good when you compare it to other products in the market. And also the shelf life is normally better. And we cannot really explain it, but probably we have less bacteria. We don't need to wash the product. So it is clean, it stays clean, and shelf life is longer normally. Yeah. Okay, so this is the overview. This is the Brightbox where we do the research. And the second slide gives an impression of two different varieties. So again, equally old. And on the left-hand side, you see a variety called Dolly from the Dutch company Enza Seeds. And on the right-hand side, the company Salvo from CN Seeds, which is an English seed company where vertical farms easily get access to good quality varieties. Seeds in small quantities, while the Dutch seed companies in general would like to sell bigger quantities of seeds. So that getting the right varieties is also an issue for vertical farming. And you can see that the varieties are completely different. Dolly is a variety with huge leaves. It's really suitable for making pesto. And Salvo is a completely different looking variety. Yeah, the shape of the leaves is different, the size of the plant is different, so you cannot compare them. And so there's a difference. And of course, in these varieties, we measured the length of the plant, the fresh weight, the dry weight, and we calculate the fresh production in a certain way in grams fresh weight per mole of photosynthetic active radiation. It says something about how efficient the variety is. And in the pictures from left to right, you see the light treatments, like in the racks in the farm. So the left-hand treatment is red and blue. Normally, cultivars stay compact because there is no far red light. And you see this with Dolly, also white with red is compact, and Dolly really reacts to far red light. If you add it, the plants stretch more. Mm-hmm. And normally you also have more kilograms. And coming back to your question about quality and the taste, you could say that you make quality by adding more blue light, and you could say that you make more kilograms by adding far red light. Okay, that's a very general sentence, of course, but here you could see how it works. And then when you go to the right hand picture, I think you can still see that with far red you produce more weight.
Yeah.
But the difference is not that big anymore, so the genetics of these two varieties is completely different. And well, we had many more varieties, and I tend to say that it is more important to choose the right variety in a simple trial than to play with the light and the rest of the climate for a very long time. I think all vertical farms should start with the variety choice in a simple way, production modules that you probably use in the farm, put all the varieties that you can get and test them, and 4 weeks later you know sort of which varieties you should continue with and which ones you should not continue with. And yeah, I hope with presentation in the symposium in autumn to give you more information about what you can expect in variety trials in general, and then the example of course is basil herbs.
Okay, well thank you very much. That's in a very short explanation the difference between the two, so thank you very much. As always, at the interview or the presentation we keep at Yakaima TV, we ask a little bit personal question, because we see you as a professional, you present as a professional about what your let's say your work, your research. But I'm always intrigued to find out a bit about you personally yourself. So I'm interested, what is your favorite hobby or sport or music or, I'm curious.
Yeah. And I promised you, because of the limited time, that I would not speak about my hobby gardening, because then we really run out of time. But then another hobby I have for many years already is to play tennis, and we do that with some friends of my age. So elderly people play tennis on Monday evening in the city of Den Bosch for an hour and a half. Yeah, the fun for me with tennis is that when you play tennis, you have to focus on the sport. You have to think in a strategic way. So you forget all your problems. You forget all the deadlines of your work, and you can really relax. And that helps me to continue with a fresh start the next day.
Okay, so thank you very much for your presentation, and I look forward to see your presentation at the Vertical Farming Conference coming October. So thank you very much.
Okay.